Paul, we've come to the end of the campaign for the Trinidad and Tobago High Performance Team. Another spirited display, but you suffered another defeat today. But generally, what are your thoughts on how things went and the display that the girls gave?
Most importantly, getting to have 36 players exposed is a big bonus for our high performance program. It's going to encourage these girls to want to stay in the game and continue playing and striving to work and play for our national teams going forward.
What are some of the good things that you would have seen from your high performance team in this tournament?
A couple of the things were, one was their willingness to compete. We saw that, you know, they have that fighting spirit in them. So, you know, moving forward, we continue helping them to improve technically and just continue trying to expose them at the highest level possible.
Tell us the difference. A lot of people ask, what is the difference between this high performance team, this group of players, and the actual national under 15 team that played in the tournament? Tell us about your group.
The two teams, you would have the team that competed last year in the CFU U14 girls, and the Trinidad and Tobago under 15 team would have been made up of most of those girls. This second group would have been a group of girls that we have been identifying along the way and bringing into the program to try to help them improve. One of the things is that we need to grow the player pool for women's football in Trinidad. And that's the importance of having a wide group of players that we're able to work with. We have more options when it comes to choosing for national teams. And even coming out of this high performance group, we've already seen two or three players that we will identify to start working with to push them to the next level.
Right. Is it their age difference? Is it like your high performance team are also under 15 girls or someone like 13, 14?
The high performance group would have some 13-year-olds that would stay on and now make up the next high performance group, which would be U13. So again, having them get this opportunity puts them a step ahead of the ones that will come after.
And is it safe to say that players from both these teams, this group, will vie for selection for our next women's under 17 team that we're going to World Cup qualifying?
Yes, this under 15 team will be the one that would graduate out of high performance to the under 17 team. And in addition to them, we do have some players that are still eligible for under 17 that couldn't play with this under 15 team. So now we have a continuous flow of players coming through one after the next that will help support all our future national teams.